Yeah, that's my favorite subject next to science.
There are students like Valentina Mendoza who easily find the fun in math.
Math kind of relates to everything, from like pie to like a normal American flag with 50 stars.
Denver Public Schools just celebrated a huge accomplishment, the highest ever math scores on last year's CMAS test. And here at Polaris Elementary, a highly gifted and talented magnet, they had the highest scores in the state. I talked to two math teachers here who say it's not just about having smart kids, it's about making sure math is more than just numbers.
When children come in, and frequently it's girls, is saying, I'm not good at math. And the response is, that's not a thing. You can't not be good at math. You just haven't clicked into it yet, but you are good at math.
At Polaris, educators from second through fifth grade teach their specific content areas. For math teachers Ian Hodges and Lisa Bornstein, the year starts with building relationships and making connections.
Who votes for heptagon?
Even the games are all part of making math relevant to these students.
I'm trying to just get to know them. If I don't care about decimals, okay, but oh wait, I'm a swimmer. So actually in the Olympics, when they swim, there's the thousands play. So if just getting to know them and where you can build those bridges between your content and what they're actually interested in.
This is elementary school, and I want them to have the foundations to go on to the highest graduate levels in math if they want. But most of all, I want them to be excited about math while they're learning it.
How do you get someone excited about graphs?
Oh, well, they're called slow reveal graphs. And the first thing that comes...
When a bar graph can get a teacher this excited and the whole class engaged, Bornstein knows she's on the right track. This graph about chocolate got the kids talking about so much more than just math.
This was about chocolate consumption per capita in countries around the world. But we were able to tie that into geography, the age of empires, resources, cultural traditions, and food. And so there were so many kids that were like sinking into this conversation who might have walked in that day saying, I hate math.
It takes creativity, but it's especially rewarding to reach those kids because even for high potential students, it's not always math that hooks them.
Some kids are here because they're really gifted in language arts, or they're artists, or they're musicians. So there's a lot of things that can bring you to Polaris. But no matter what, we're doing the same kind of stuff in math class.
Algorithm, area, angle, addition.
We work on our math vocabulary. We work on being able to explain our thinking, because there's so many ways that you can memorize an algorithm and learn to compute and calculate. But if you can explain what it is that you're doing, then it doesn't really matter how advanced the math is.
It's still important to learn the basics, the formulas, the properties, but the hope is that students are making connections along the way and enjoying it, to the point where even a test can be another fun day in math.
Math tests are like stress-worthy, but like when you get into them, you kind of can't stop.
Well, at least for Valentina, tests are fun. These Polaris students should be proud of their CMAS test scores, the highest in Colorado. Their teachers say it's a victory for so many others as well.
Victory for the fourth grade math teacher, the third grade math teacher, the second, the first, because it just all builds. I'm just shuffling them into the next realm and then trying to help them synthesize it all.
Yep.
This is a job that you have never completed and never perfected. So you get a little moment of, oh, I'm on the right path. Cool, let's keep going.
A big congratulations to all the DPS students who made big gains on last year's CMAS math tests. For more information on your school, just scan the QR code. I'm Nicole Brady for DPS.